Hello and welcome to a new video here on my channel at commaikE. In my project of slope stabilization with gabions, I have reached part 7. As you can see, I am getting closer, the finale. In the lower row, I only have only a few baskets left to fill. However, I would like to start the second one already now to set up the row. How I go about it and how I do the whole thing. Stay tuned and stay with us, as I will definitely demonstrate it to you in just a few moments. To stabilize the slope that you can see up here, the lower row of the gabions has been built. Here in this area, it will be completely double layered. I want to bring the slope to the height we need, up here just below this tree stump. Originally, it was my first plan to fill all the baskets down here completely, and then to apply the second layer. Unfortunately, a problem has arisen. If I now simply go with the perspective to the last two baskets, as you can clearly observe, you can see that the entire structure is noticeably bulging out at the back. That's not a problem. With the grid that will go on top, I haven't quite managed to get everything back together. Unfortunately, I'm not that far yet that I can attach the grids everywhere. So I will now start building the second row of baskets for this. I will start with assembly of the connection grids. Second row here on the left half, the upper baskets are still empty and are used as a starting point. The lower ones, I have already filled the baskets. I will now attach the separating grids and install the additional gabions up here at the first basket. It's getting really exciting. As you can see, the stone baskets the sides are not exactly the same length. If I now take the grid, just lay it here, the grid will be secured here, then you will see here that the original basket would have reached this far, but it no longer fits because of the curve I built here. I will only place the rear grid up to here and let it go back here. And then just simply place it behind the other grid. I will of course do the same on the front side with the fine mesh grid. Here, everything is flush because the front side is exactly 1 meter long. As you can see, the grids are not quite flush. The front grid and the lid fits quite well together, but the bottom grid is already quite far away so that I can still easily and effectively insert the spirals. I will carefully and securely pull these together with cable ties and then carefully, gently and slowly screw in the spiral with precision. After I have installed the front grid, I can take care of middle divider grids, secured at bottom with a spiral is fastened. On the sides, a large spiral is added again. When screwing in the large spiral, I also have to attach the next front grid and to proceed with the installation, carefully install the next rear grid component at the same time as other parts. Ensure all necessary tools are ready. Begin by aligning the grid properly, checking for obstructions. Once aligned, secure it firmly using appropriate fasteners. Double check connections for stability and safety. This step is crucial for the assembly and functionality of the system. I have now twisted the two long spirals of the second stone basket. Of course, this part in the middle became quite exciting. Through these four grids that have overlapped here, I have the spiral. Simply could not get through anymore. Therefore, I removed the spiral from twisted at the back while fastening three of the four grids. However, I think due to the weight that will later be on the two, grids are located on the left and right, such as the necessary stability is ensured. If I shake the grid now, it is already stable and firm. This should definitely hold. I bent the spirals again. Ensuring that it is crimped correctly and securely with the pliers using the appropriate tools and techniques. I will spray the scratches from the pliers with zinc spray to prevent rust. Now it's time to fill the gabions with my granite stones. I still have a few left to do, as you can see. I will now align it flush to the left. Continue, first with this small stone basket, then with the larger ones. When I finish one of the lower stone baskets, I will place the second row on top. Since the last cut, I have actually been experimenting a bit more and found a better solution from my perspective. As you can see, I have almost completely assembled the baskets of the second row, although the bottom row is not yet completely filled. I was able to completely assemble the first two stone baskets. The lower gabions are already filled. As you can see, I have made myself with zip ties made the work a bit easier. The tension of the grids was quite high. After that, I connected the cross grids, the front grids, and the back grids with the spirals. For the unfilled baskets, I did everything like as follows. I carefully threaded the back wall, ensuring it included the bottom grid. I securely and carefully connected the back walls to each other and the cross grid. I just simply folded up the bottom a little bit more. Once the basket is filled, I fold it down. It remains up for filling. In this way, I connected all the back walls together. The cross grid, which is connected at the back to the two rear walls. I have secured it as a precaution. I will unscrew this spiral after filling it. Then I will fold down the grid and connect with the spiral. At the corners, it has become a bit more complicated. Since the ground grids overlapped, I could only bend them upwards with force. Once the lower stone baskets are filled, I can also put on the lids here. Fold down and install the cross grids. The reason for my change of plans is actually quite simple. As you can see in the bottom row, I have on the back of the baskets, a protective fabric is applied. This protects the gabions from saturation, mud, and dirt. At the same time, the earth is also necessary to build the required counterpressure. Since I built the baskets with a slight slope, the top row should of course also be backfilled with soil. For that, I also need to install the protective fleece there. Now that I have attached the back grids of all the baskets, I can also very carefully attach the protective fleece up here. With the fabric, I am now able to fill the soil already. This way, I can already start removing the slope up here and take care of my irrigation. But that is another story as it continues to unfold. At the moment, I need to continue filling the gabions with stones. This act will certainly take another week or two. If you want to know what it looks like afterwards and how it continues from there, just stay tuned and subscribe to my channel, hit the bell, and you will automatically informed as soon as there is a new video from me. Thank you for watching and see you soon.